Question 31 says a body projected at 45 degree to the horizontal with a velocity of 30 meter per second has a range of 60 meters. The decrease in range due to the air resistance is. The student, without air resistance, the range is calculated using the formula. R is equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. And this will be equal to 30 square sine 2 theta, that is 2 into 45 by 10. And this, the student, will be equal to 90 meters. However, it is given that practically the range is found to be equal to 60 meters. So the decrease in range, that is delta R, will be equal to 90 minus 60, that is 30 meters. As we can see from the option, the correct answer should be option number 4. Now let us move to the question number 32. In question 32, it is possible to project a particle with a given speed in two possible ways so that it has the same horizontal range. If the time of flight in the two cases are t1 and t2, then the speed of the projection of the particle will be. Now let us solve this question, dear student. The time of flight in the case of projectile is given as 2u sine theta by g. This is a very important formula. Now, first time t1 is written as 2u sine theta by g. From this, sine theta will be equal to gt1 by 2u. While in the second case, t2 will be equal to 2u sine 90 minus theta by g. And this, dear student, will be equal to 2u cos theta by g. Now, one thing that we have to remember here is that the range is same for the two cases when the angles of projection add up to be 90 degree. So if one angle is theta, the other angle will be 90 minus theta. This is the concept that we have used here. From this, we can write down that cos theta will be equal to g t2 by 2u. Also, we know that square of sine and cos, the sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, which means that g t1 by 2u whole square plus g t2 by 2u whole square is equal to 1, giving us that u will be equal to g by 2 under root of t1 square plus t2 square. So hence, just when the correct answer for this question should be option number 1. Now let us move to the question number 33. In this question, a stone is projected from top of a tower with velocity 20 meter per second, making an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal. If the total time of flight of the particle to reach the ground is 5 seconds, then the maximum height of the stone above the ground is. The student, let us draw a diagram. Let this be tower of height h. It is projected at an angle of 30 degree. Now, let the height of the tower, let us represent that by h2, while the height of the projectile be h1. So we can find out h1 and h2 and add them. Now, dear student, the angle at which the particle will cross the same height will be again 30 degree with the horizontal. Now, the time of flight, that is the t1 till the same height, total time be t2. Let us find out the t1. T1 will be simply the time of flight of the projectile, that is 2u sine theta by g. That will be 2 into 20 into sine 30 by 10, and this will be equal to 2 seconds. The total time is given to be equal to, that is t2, which is the total time, is given to be equal to 5 seconds. So this will be 5 minus 2, that is equal to 3 seconds. So the time taken from this point to this point is equal to 3 seconds. Now, dear student, the height h1 can be written from the formula of the projectile, that is u square sine square theta by 2g, that is 20 square sine square 30 by 2g is equal to 5 meter, while h2 can be written as u sine theta t, that is from the vertical motion only, plus half g t square, that is 10 into 3 plus half into 10 into 3 square. So this will be equal to 75 meter, the total height being 75 plus 5, that is equal to 80 meters. And as we can see from the given option, the correct answer should be option number 1. Now let us proceed to the next question. Question 34 says a body is projected with a velocity v at an angle of 53 degrees to the horizontal. The time at which it will be moving in the direction of 45 degree to the horizontal is. The student, if the particle is moving at an angle of alpha with the horizontal, then we can actually write down that tan alpha will be equal to vertical velocity by horizontal velocity. The vertical velocity at any time can be written as v sine theta minus gt, and the horizontal velocity will be always v cos theta. So this is the formula that we can use here to solve the question. From this, tan 45 will be equal to v sine 53 minus gt by v cos 53. We have just substituted the values, and on solving this we get a value of t to be equal to v by 5g, meaning that the correct answer for this question is option number 4. Now let us move to the question number 35. Question 35 says a boatman finds that he can save 4 seconds in crossing a river by quicker path than by shortest path. If velocity of boat and river be respectively 10 meter per second and 6 meter per second, then width of the river will be. Notice, student, in case 1, that is for the shortest time, let us draw a diagram. Let this be the river and the width be d. This will be the velocity of the boatman, and in the shortest time it is moving perpendicular to the river current only. The time will be equal to d by vb, meaning that t will be equal to d by 10, as 10 is the velocity of the boat. Now, dear student, in case 2, for the shortest path, the boat will be moving at a certain angle, but will essentially move in the perpendicular to the river current direction. This is vr, this is vb, and this will be equal to under root of vb square minus vr square. Now, dear student, the time t1 can be written as d by under root vb square minus vr square. This will be equal to t by under root 10 square minus 6 square, meaning that t1 will be equal to d by 8. It is also given that the difference in the time, that is t1 is actually equal to t plus 4, that is the difference in time is 4. On substituting the values, we can write down that d by 8 is equal to d by 10 plus 4, giving us a value of d to be equal to 160 meters. And hence for this question, the correct answer is option number 2. Now let us move to the question number 36.